Hello, everyone, and welcome to our Vendo podcast. I'm Daria Smailova, digital media buyer here at Vendo, and today I will be covering a very important topic for Amazon advertisers: guide to Facebook ad types driving traffic back to Amazon. As all of us know, Facebook ads are one of the most powerful external traffic sources for Amazon sellers. A successful Facebook ad campaign will benefit you by way of increased sales velocity, which leads to a higher VSR, better rankings, and more profit. You can also collect leads with Facebook ads, and you can create lead generation ads and build a powerful list of potential customers. You can create custom audiences and you can create lookalike audiences. All this helps for you to get an edge over your competitors. The vast majority of Amazon sellers never use outside traffic sources like Facebook ads. As we discussed in previous episodes, the best practice is to drive Facebook ad traffic to a landing page, but you can also send traffic straight to your listing. There are plenty of landing page builders out there. We just need to pick whatever suits your needs and create that beautiful landing page. So the first step is actually to have a Facebook business manager. Believe it or not, but some advertisers, they're still using their native ads manager tool, which is supposedly created for personal use. If you're a brand, create your own business account and set up a Facebook business manager. Once you're ready to create your Facebook ad campaign, go to your business manager and select an objective. There are three main objectives when you create Facebook ad campaign. First is awareness, second is consideration, and third is conversion. Most of them are used for driving traffic back to your website, but there are two main objectives that I recommend to use to drive traffic back to Amazon. So what's your marketing objective? In Facebook ad campaigns, there are three main marketing objectives. The first one is awareness, and there you can create a brand awareness campaign and reach campaign. Both of those objectives are great when you drive traffic back to your website. The second objective in Facebook Business Manager is consideration, and that consists of traffic ad campaigns, engagement ad campaigns, app installs, video views, and lead generation. For Amazon, we recommend to use traffic ad objective. The third one will be conversions, with conversions, product catalog sales, and store visits. And there we recommend to use conversion ad campaigns to drive traffic back to Amazon. The ideal conversion event when you create an ad campaign to drive traffic back to your landing page would be a lead. So whenever you create a conversion ad, select a lead objective in your conversions. So the traffic ad objectives is the best when you're driving traffic back to your Amazon listing or your Amazon brand store. Make sure that you're using Pixel 5 Me links or any URL shorteners where you can track your impressions and your visits and your link clicks through those links. When you're driving traffic back to the brand store, you can see all of that data in the Amazon's backend. So let's go to the ad types. Whenever we create a lead generation ad campaign, when we want to create leads and drive traffic to your landing page, I would suggest to select a lead event in the ad campaign. If you're running campaign for the first time, this event will show in the red because you have never run a lead generation event. So for that, you will need to optimize your ad campaign, and you will need to create an ad campaign that is optimized first for landing page views. Landing page views ad campaign is similar to a traffic ad campaign, but that campaign is tracking not clicks, but landing page views, which is meaning that a customer actually stayed on the page and had some action on it instead of just clicking the link. Now that you selected your ad objective, and again, for driving traffic back to Amazon, I recommend selecting traffic ad campaigns and conversions. In our case, if you're driving traffic back to your landing page, that will be lead event conversion ad campaign. So now you want to define your audience targeting. This is the most important part of your Facebook campaign setup. The more you know about your market, the easier it will be. Creating an audience essentially lets you target people based on a number of characteristics, including age, location, interest, or behavior, and it's very powerful. Facebook Ad Manager is one of the most sophisticated ad platforms out there. It also can target people by their income, by their interest, by their status, by their marital status, economic status. So there is a lot of to choose out there, so you have to make sure you know your audience. Here are a couple of things that you need to consider when building your audience. First of all, create an audience of at least of 10,000 people. The more people exposed to your ad, especially if you're setting up for first time, the better. Second of all, be as specific as possible. Use detailed targeting. For example, target people by keywords and interest. You can enter up to 175 keyword clouds. That's interest clouds in Facebook interest, precise interest targeting. So you can target people, for example, interested in fitness, interested in health, healthy lifestyle and healthy eating and nutrition. And you can go on and on in your keyword search. So make sure you're as detailed as possible and you're covering as many keyword clouds as possible. Because interest targeting is very powerful. Make sure that you include Amazon.com as an interest to ensure that people who are enthusiastic about Amazon and Amazon customers are also among your target audience. Another powerful feature of lead generation ad campaigns on Facebook is actually collecting leads. Once you've collected enough leads, you can create your custom audience out of that email list. So what would I recommend is to upload that email list and you can use it in Facebook targeting for your ad campaign to drive traffic back to Amazon. The second option will be to create lookalike audiences out of that email list. Facebook will match the data from that email list and will create 1 up to 10% match lookalike audiences. For example, if you have an email list of 10,000 people, it would create 1, 2, 3% match based on the interest, based on their geolocation, their salary, their marital situation, and it will create people who are more likely to be like the customer that you have on your list. So creating lookalike audience is a very powerful tool. Once you've selected your targeting, now it's time to set up your budget. Whenever you create traffic or lead generation ad campaigns, I would recommend to start from testing those ad campaigns for at least a week or two. So you can gather enough data, you can see which ad or which targeting is performing the best, which imagery or ad copy. I also highly recommend to A/B test your ads. So for budgeting, I would recommend to start at least from $50 per day so you can have enough data on your cost per click or cost per acquisition or cost per lead in the case if you're using lead generation ad campaigns. I would also recommend to leave the budget optimization up to Facebook. So Facebook knows when to spend the most. I would not recommend to use manual bidding in this case. Once you set up your budget, it's time to set up creative and launch your ad. For traffic ad campaigns and for lead generation ad campaigns, I would recommend to use a compelling imagery or videos, and the copy should be as precise, short, and sweet as possible. I would also recommend to use links that will drive traffic back to Amazon listing or to use a brand store link. Once you launch your ad, you're ready to go. To track the results, it's very important to look at your campaign performance at least once or twice per day. I would recommend to stay on top of your campaign stats so you can make sure that you optimize your ad campaign and you don't end up spending a lot of money on something that doesn't work. In the early days of your campaign, make sure to check your results, as I said, daily or twice per day. Facebook ads can be very powerful to drive traffic back to Amazon and to help you with your sales and your conversions. Since you cannot install Facebook Pixel on Amazon, we highly recommend to use landing pages where you can install your Facebook Pixel and you can track visits, clicks, and conversions. Also, running Facebook ads back to Amazon can help you with your bestseller ranking, with your ranking overall to get more sales and new reviews. You can also use Facebook ads to collect leads, and from those leads, you can create custom audiences and you can create lookalike audiences that will help you to broaden your retargeting pool. As a conclusion, I would like to say that setting up Facebook ad campaigns isn't that hard. It is very important, though, to know which ad objective to select when you're creating your Facebook ad campaign, driving traffic back to Amazon. It is also very important to check your stats and to know how to improve and optimize your ad campaign. Let us know if you have any questions, subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on our social media, and hit us up if you have any questions. I hope to see you in the next episode. Thank you. Bye.